Karnataka, our very senior leader, Sri B.S. Yedurappa ji, our president of the Bharatiya Janata Party, Sri Nalin Kateel ji, the All India General Secretary, Sri Muralidhar Rao ji, Sri Govind Karjol ji, the Deputy CM of Karnataka, Sri Ashwath Narayan ji, the Deputy CM of Karnataka, Tejaswi Surya, who is the local member of parliament and my colleague in the parliament, a young budding leader of Karnataka, Sri Satish Reddy ji, the MLA, and a very dear friend of mine, and Sri N.R. Ramesh ji, the president of Bharatiya Janata Party, and the distinguished gathering, the eminent people of Karnataka and Bangalore, and friends from media, the electronic media and print media. It is indeed a matter of great happiness and an opportunity for me to be present here and to address such a gathering which is the leaders in their own walk of life and in their own way. And it is an opportunity for me to address such a gathering. When I came to this place, I asked, what is the content, what content should be there for addressing such an elite gathering? My friends suggested me that I should speak on the policies and programs of the government of India, led by our dynamic leader, Sri Narendra Modi ji. They also wanted me to touch issues which Modi II government has done after May, and especially issues related to the ideological, in the ideological background, what we have done. No doubt when we talk about Article 370, we can say that as far as our ideology is concerned, which started its activities in 1952, at that point of time, we were very clear with the slogan that Ek Desh Mein Do Vidhan, Do Samvidhan, Do Pradhan, Do Nishan Nahin Chalegi. So we were very clear that there will be one constitution, one nation, one president, one prime minister, and one flag, one national flag and one national anthem. We were very clear about it. But we all know that right from the independence, when more than 560 princely states were united under the dynamic leadership of Vallabhai Patel, Jammu Kashmir also was the part of the accession to the Union of India. But the accession was not complete. The accession was not complete because of the policies adopted at that point of time by Jawaharlal Nehru. And that policy was to give special status to Jammu and Kashmir. We all know that Article 370 came into existence. We all know that with a lot of discussion in the Constituent Assembly, it was Mr. Iyengar who proposed that there will be an Article 370 which will be temporary in nature and it will be transitional, and because Jammu Kashmir, there is a war going on, so at that point of time we need a special status which was called as Article 370. We also know that it was opposed tooth and nail by B.R. Ambedkar, who said in his words, I quote, that you want that we should build your, construct your roads. You want that we should give you food and other facilities. You want that we should defend you. You want that all facilities be given to you. But you do not want to become a part of India. This is intolerable, we will not do it. That was B.R. Ambedkar who has said this to Sheikh Abdullah at that time. Anyway, we all know that in 50s, I don't exactly remember the date, but it was in 1954, that when the election took place, Sheikh Abdullah did not implement in 1951 the People's Representation Act in Jammu Kashmir. And that is why all 75 seats, 3 seats were to be fought by Prajapati Party, Praja Parishad. By force, they were not allowed to fight, and all 75 seats were won by Sheikh Abdullah and his men. And after that, the language of Sheikh Abdullah got changed. He started speaking the Legislative Assembly as a sovereign body. He always started saying that it is a sovereign body and it is going to decide the fate of Jammu and Kashmir. Although the accession was complete, in accession it was said all the landed area which has been under the rule of Maharaja Hari Singh is fully in accession to the Union of India. So the whole landed area was Jammu Kashmir was fully in accession. But at that point of time, Sheikh Abdullah started saying that no, it is a sovereign body and sovereign power we have, and so we will decide our own fate. At that time, at that point of time, there was a pact which happened between Sheikh Abdullah and Jawaharlal Nehru. And at that point of time, it was decided that we will give them a separate the bills passed by the Union of India in the Parliament will have to be ratified by the Jammu Kashmir Assembly. And after ratification, it will be applicable in the state of Jammu Kashmir. The another thing which we accepted was that they will have a governor, and that governor will be elected by the Legislative Assembly. And the third thing was that they will have a separate flag, and the Chief Minister will be called as Prime Minister. This is how they started a story of separation in Jammu and Kashmir. And we all know that in times to come, slowly, although the Indian Constitution, the President of India made it very clear that there will be no Prime Minister, it will be Chief Minister, and it happened so. But they had their own flag also. Later on, we were fighting for abrogation of Article 370. And you all know that on 6th of August, we were able and successful. And the dream which all of us had that we will have one nation, one Pradhan, one Nishan, that was successful, and Article 370 was abrogated. And it was done in letter and spirit. Now, after the abrogation, questions have been raised that the people of Jammu Kashmir will not be in the mainstream. Here I would like to clarify, and I would like to make it very clear, that the people of Jammu Kashmir are very much in the mainstream, and they are much happier. This I am speaking because I have been in charge of Jammu Kashmir for 6 long years, and I know what media presents about Jammu and Kashmir. At the grassroots level, Jammu and Kashmir is absolutely different. That is what we have to understand. And this I'm saying with full authority in command. You see, those who are not happy, who are those people? It is few political parties. It is few family political parties who had the advantage of playing a role where they took the advantage from Government of India, but at the same time they were never trying to suppress the separatist forces. And because of this conflict, they were having a gala time. So it is they who are not happy. But the people of Jammu Kashmir are very much happy. This we have to understand. And I'm not saying, I'm saying with facts. You see, when the Article 370 has been abrogated, how it has brought life to the people of Jammu Kashmir. You'll be astonished to know that in Jammu Kashmir, there is no political reservation for tribals. Now, this Congress party, All India level, they talk about tribals. All political parties talk about tribals. But you'll be astonished to know that till date, there has been no representation, political representation to tribals. There are Gujarwals, there are Bakarwals, there are Gujars. They are all Muslims, they are all nationalists. They fight along with Indian Army against Pakistan. That is the nationalist character of Gujars and Bakarwals. The whole Leh and Ladakh is tribal, the whole Leh and Ladakh. But there is no political reservation in Ladakh. But after the abrogation of Article 370, delimitation will take place. And now for the first time, a Gujar, a Barkarwal on a tribal seat will come to the Vidhan Sabha and to the Lok Sabha. This is the victory. So you can understand how people are happy about the abrogation of Article 370. Rajiv Gandhi brought the Constitutional Amendment Act of 73 and 74, where the direct powers were given to the Panchayat Pradhans. You all remember. But this was not implemented in Jammu Kashmir. Ghulam Nabi Azad was the Chief Minister of Jammu Kashmir. But he never implemented, and the 73rd, 74th amendment was not implemented in Jammu Kashmir. So the money used to go to the treasury of Jammu Kashmir, and they used to decide whether they are going to give it to Panchayat or not. But now, when Modi ji sends money, it goes directly to the Panchayat Pradhan, and it's directly reaching to the people. And money is not a small amount. Each Panchayat is getting approximately 3 to 4 crores for development every year. And this is how people have seen the change, and which change is coming at the grassroots level. You will be astonished to know that we had two prime ministers and one deputy prime minister who came from West Pakistan and became the prime minister here in India. One is Manmohan Singh, another is Indra Kumar Gujral, and deputy prime minister, our beloved leader, Sri L.K. Advani. All came from West Pakistan. But they fought elections here and they became. But in Jammu Kashmir, you were not allowed even to stand for a councillor because of Article 370. And Article 370 gave the power that there is a permanent resident citizenship and there is a non-permanent resident citizenship. Only permanent resident citizenship can fight election. So not even a single councillor from the West Pakistan who came and settled in Jammu Kashmir could fight an election. But after this abrogation, now you can fight for MP also, MLA also, and for Pradhan also, and for BDC also. This is the change which has taken place. In Jammu Kashmir, you will be astonished to know, the Congress party and all political parties talk about scheduled caste, our leaders, Dalit leaders. You will be astonished to know that the Chief Minister of Jammu Kashmir brought Balmikis from Punjab, made them settle in Jammu Kashmir. And when it came to give them jobs, till date, they were only given jobs of Safai Karmchari and none other. Only Safai Karmchari. This was the democratic state of Jammu Kashmir. But after abrogation of Article 370, now these Valmikis, their son can even become doctor in a medical hospital or a judicial officer or an administrative officer in Jammu Kashmir. That is the situation which has taken place. This is the change which has taken place. 106 bills and act which has been passed, bills which has become an act and which has been passed and which is implemented in government of in length and breadth of the country are not implemented in Jammu Kashmir. Now it is being abrogated. Because of the abrogation, they are being implemented. You will be astonished to know that the Anti-Corruption Act was not applicable in Jammu Kashmir. So bring funds from Government of India, have a gala time, nobody is going to ask, and do whatever you like, and always speak in favor of Article 370 and enjoy. Now the inquiry has started. Jammu Kashmir Bank inquiry has started. Now the leaders who have done corruption will be either in jail or on bail. That is the situation which has come. You will be astonished to know, here Modi ji is trying to make POSCO very, very stringent. Prevention of children against sexual act. Even for a minor, if a rape takes place, there is a provision for sentence to death. But this POSCO was not implemented in state of Jammu Kashmir. Violence against women, this was not implemented in state of Jammu Kashmir. If a lady, if a female from Jammu Kashmir marries a non-resident citizen outside Jammu Kashmir, she was denied the property rights for that lady from the ancestral property. But now after the abrogation of Article 370, They have got every right in property there in Jammu Kashmir. This is Article 370 abrogation which has taken place. So now the lifestyle, they are now the Jammu Kashmir for the first time has come into the mainstream. And I'll give you a classic example. In December, there was, for the first time after independence, they had the BDC election. Block Development Council. 310 blocks election were held. You will be happy to note that BJP has won 70 seats. Panthers party has won 7 seats. Congress party has won only 1 seat. And NCP, National Conference, NC, and PDP, they did not participate in the elections. And all seats have been won by independent candidates. You will be happy to note that the percentage of polling in Sofia was 86%. You will be happy to note that the percentage of polling in Pulwama was 85%. You will be happy to note that in Srinagar, the polling was 96%. And you will be happy to know that BDC election in Sofia has won by Bharatiya Janata Party. I'm giving you the examples. This is an example which can show that now Jammu Kashmir is in the mainstream and not even a single case of violence has occurred during the election. Not even a single case. This is people's democracy. This is coming into the mainstream. Now people realize that when Modi sends money, it does not go into the treasury of Jammu Kashmir. It comes directly to the people of Jammu Kashmir for their benefit. This is the change which has taken place. So friends, when we talk about, media talks about Jammu Kashmir mein kya ho raha hai, kaisa chalega, kya hoga. Many MPs and many international delegations have visited Jammu Kashmir and they know. So it is not only the abrogation of Article 370. The major work is that Jammu Kashmir is now in the mainstream of the country. That is the something which we have to realize, and that is what Modi has done, and that is what we have to understand. And we must appreciate the craftsmanship of Amit Shah. Nobody believed that it will be possible. Everybody was talking that it will get entangled in legal battle. But with fine acumen, he brought this bill and got it passed in 2 days. And on the third day, with the president of the Senate, Article 370 was abrogated, which was a dream for not for me, not for you, but for crores and crores of people of this country. If I talk about triple talaq, it was Supreme Court who had given the direction, but they didn't have the political will. They could not bring a law for it. And the sole reason was that the Congress party, the UPA, and all the political parties have got one thing in mind: vote bank first, country last. It is Bharatiya Janata Party will believes country first and party last. National interest cannot be compromised for political parties' interest. But they believe in vote bank politics. It was Modi ji's political will which decided that we will have triple talaq, we will do away with triple talaq, and we did it. The bill was brought and was passed by the, and was brought by the law ministry, and we are very thankful to all member parliament who supported us. But what did Congress party say? Hum to karna chahte the, lekin mahilaon ke bare mein hamara vichar kuch is prakar se tha, jin hamari kuch shankaen thi. आपकी कोई शंका नहीं थी, आपकी एक ही शंका थी, वो वोट बैंक की राजनीति की शंका थी और कुछ नहीं था. यू आर प्लेइंग वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स, नथिंग एल्स, नथिंग इन योर माइंड. इट वाज ओनली वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स. बट आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट वी हैव गॉट द मॉरल करेज टू ब्रिंग ट्रिपल तलाक, एंड मोदी जी हैज शोन दैट पॉलिटिकल विल टू डू अवे विद ट्रिपल तलाक. एंड यू विल बी एस्टॉनिश्ड टू नो दैट वी हैव गॉट द मॉरल करेज बिकॉज we had done away with sati pratha, we have done away with dowry, we have brought stringent laws for child marriage, we have brought very social changes, drastic changes in our own society. So why we should keep this triple talaq for Muslim women? They should be also liberated, and that Modi ji has done. And you will be astonished to know that in Pakistan there is no triple talaq. In Bangladesh, it's an Islamic country. There's no triple talaq. In Afghanistan, there's no triple talaq. In Iran, there is no triple talaq. In Malaysia, which the majority of the people are Muslims, there is no triple talaq. There are many countries, Islamic countries, where there is no triple talaq. But we as secular nation, secularism meant for in India is the appeasement of the minority vote. That is called secularism. And what Modi ji says, sabka saath, sabka vikas, sabka vishwas. Appeasement of none, but mainstreaming of everyone. So in triple talaq also, we did the same thing. I am very happy to note that when the judgment of Ram Janmabhoomi came, utmost restraint was shown, and the fabric, the social fabric of this country took a very conscious decision that we have to maintain the social fabric and peace has to be maintained. Although crores and crores of Indians felt happy, but at the same time, we also took care of the sentiments of the other sections of the society. And it was mainstreaming which was done. But you see the maturity of our political party. We believed in the legal system and we went through the legal system. And we got the justice as it came. But we, with that respect also, we'd like to say that there was one lawyer of Congress party who again had a political color here. What did he say in Supreme Court? He said, don't pass the judgment before 2019 because BJP is going to benefit out of it. See, nation is not important. Issues which should be settled, that is not important. For them, it is important that how they can politically gain and what will be political loss to them. But anyway, we respect the judgment of Supreme Court, and certainly it has decided the more than 500 years controversy about Ram Janmabhoomi, and ab to wahan bhavya mandir banega, uske liye bhi aap sabko shubhkamnaen. If I talk about CAA, we should first understand the background of CAA, Citizens Amendment Act, which was previously known as CAB, CAB, Citizens Amendment Bill, which was passed January. Now what is this? It has got a background. First of all, that the independence took place in 1947. And when the independence took place, very unfortunate thing had happened. And that unfortunate thing was that the country was divided on the basis of religion. This was the most unfortunate thing which has happened. We got independence, but at the same time, India got divided also. And on basis of religion. And we accepted, our leaders accepted, which was a blunder. But it happened. And there was lakhs of people migrating from and exchanging the borders. It has been the most human tragedy of the century, where lakhs of people had to face trouble. Lakhs of people. There's a deep scar. Even today, when you talk to any refugee, he will come out. He will talk about his ancestors, how they had to face, how they came, and how they had to face it. But it happened. It was the greatest human tragedy which took place of the century. That is what I would like to say. But it happened. At that point of time, Mahatma Gandhi said that our people, means Hindus, who are there in Pakistan, east or west, because at that time there was no Bangladesh. If they wish to come to India, it is our responsibility to bring them, settle them, and even give them government service. That was said by Mahatma Gandhi in Birla prayers. Jawaharlal Nehru said that those who are facing religious persecution on the basis of religion, they should be brought back to India, and we should give them funds, we should release funds from the relief fund of India. That is what was said by Jawaharlal Nehru at that point of time. Lohia also said the same thing later on. Many leaders, in Manmohan Singh on 18 December 2003, appealed to the Deputy Prime Minister, Mr. Lal Krishna Advani, that there are people who are being religiously persecuted in Pakistan. Please see to it that they are brought to India and they are settled here. This is what has been said by leaders because of religious persecution going on. When the division took place, there was later on there was a pact between Liaquat Ali and Jawaharlal Nehru, Liaquat Nehru pact. What was that pact? That we will see that all the minorities, though Muslims were minority here in India, and the Hindus were minority there in Pakistan, East and West Pakistan, Hindu, Jain, Sikh, Parsi, all. So we will see to it that they get the security and they are brought into the mainstream. This is the responsibility of the state. That was the Nehru-Liaquat Pact. But that Nehru-Liaquat Pact was on papers. Factually, what happened? India's constitution was socialist secular. We declared secular state. And Pakistan, East and West declared Islamic state. They declared that it's an Islamic state. So Islam is their state religion. And from there, the religious persecution started. You will be astonished to know that in 1947, the Hindu percentage, Hindu, Christian, Sikh, Isai, Sikh, Christians and Jains, the percentage was 23%. Today in Pakistan, it is 3%. Where the 20% have gone? In Bangladesh, we had 23 to 24%. Now we are 7%. Where that percentage has gone? Where those Hindus have gone? Either they have been religiously persecuted and they have converted their religion, or the rest have come to India. And who are they? They are mostly Dalits. Namo Shudras. I can give you the names also if I'll just... Yeah. They are mostly the Dalits. They are the Rajvanshis, Jalia, thousands of Malo, Teli, Bagri, Ravidas, Ruidas, Rishi Chamarkar, Dhoba, Dom. These are these Dalits who have been religiously persecuted. And they, for the cause of saving their religion, have come to India. That is what we have to understand. And everybody wanted that they should be, because they have come with religious persecution, they are in minority there. They have to be supported by the government of India. Each political party said, Manmohan Singh said, Jawaharlal Nehru said, Gandhiji said, everybody said. But they didn't have the political will because of the vote bank politics. It was Prime Minister Modi who had the will and he decided that Citizen Amendment Act will be implemented. And those people who have been religiously persecuted, they should be made the citizens of this country. I was the health minister. Previously, Mr. Advani gave me a ring and he said that there are few doctors who have come from Pakistan. You allow them to practice here. I met the delegation. One of the doctors said that I had my younger sister was there. They abducted my sister in front of me. They married him to an elder person. Later on, I went to the police station. The police officer said, that you are a Hindu, this is an Islamic state, I will not lodge an FIR. Because you are a Hindu, that is what it was said to him. And after that, he went to the mosque, he had a compromise with the clergy, and after that, he got her sister released, he ran and he came to India. He wanted to practice here in India. But the framework was such that I could not allow him to practice in India because he had his MBBS certificate of Pakistan, which was not duly recognized by us. I told Advaniji that at this point of time, I will not be able to help, but I want to help. Today, I can say that now they are the citizens of this country, they will become the citizens of that country, and they will have every right to practice in this country. This is going to happen. This is mainstream. Thousands of people in Afghanistan, it's not me who is saying. Reuters said that in 1980, in Afghanistan, there were 50,000 Sikh families. And today they say there are only 2,000 families left. Where have those 48,000 people gone? They have come, they are still, many of them have come to Delhi. They are there, since 1990 they are there. They do not have the right to purchase a property. They do not get, they can't get a government job. Their children cannot study because they are not the citizens of this country. Mainstreaming has to be done. Now after the Citizen Amendment Act, they are going to become the citizens of this country. Whoever on 31st December 2014 has come here, he will be the citizen of this country. That is what has been provided. Now there is a lot of hue and cry. Yesterday you heard the debate. Gulam Nabi Azad also said, no, no, humko isse koi problem nahi hai. Are problem nahi hai, to Shaheen Bagh kahan se aaya? Aur tum wahan bhashan dene aapke neta kyun gaye the? Why did they go there? Again, it's a hypocritical politics. It is double standards. It is not thinking about the nation. It is thinking about the vote bank politics. That is why they are doing this. But anyway, yesterday it was, everything was clear. They had to agree upon. Gulam Nabi Azad ne kaha, hame koi isse aapatti nahi hai. Are aapatti nahi hai, to itne dino se kar kya rahe ho? What you are doing? You didn't allow the parliament to function. You wanted a debate. We were ready for the debate. We had debate. And of course, CA was passed after duly debating in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Everybody got an opportunity. And after that, it has been passed. And you see, in internationally, the image should go that we are so accommodative that we try to bring people on religious persecution and we are giving them citizenship here in the country. But they wanted to spoil the image of the country. That is what they wanted to do. But with your support, we can say, and under Modiji's leadership, India is going forward day in and day out, and we are trying to, under his leadership, we see that now India stands on a very different platform. And the classic example was when Donald Trump had come, that at that point of time, the speech which he gave, in which for 28 minutes he spoke about India and Modi, that is what we have to understand, and that is his way this time. So this is what we have to understand. The image has changed. And whoever wanted to do the Delhi riots, it was yesterday, Honorable Home Minister has said about it, detailed that conspiracy will come in due course of time. But they wanted to spoil the image of the country. It was not spontaneous. There were events after events were going on only to see to it that when Trump comes, the image of the country, which will be at its height, that should not be there. That was the sole purpose. Friend, one thing more I would like to say, that on the socio-economic side, India has taken a great stride. We, as a political ideology, believe in Antyodaya. Antyodaya means the betterment of the last person standing in the society, helping the last person who among the have-nots, and to support it. All programs, if we talk about financial inclusion, Jan Dhan Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Bima Yojana, Atal Pension Yojana, Kisan Mandhan Yojana, all are committed to the people who need the help of Government of India. Ujjwala Yojana, distributing gas cylinders to 8 crore our women of the Indian society. This Ujjala Yojana, distributing 36.36 crore LED bulbs. If I talk about my Ayushman Bharat, I say my Ayushman Bharat because Modi ji gave me an opportunity when I was the health minister. He came out with Ayushman Bharat. You see, World Health Organization's target is that 1 billion people should be brought in under health coverage. 1 billion people. That is the World Health Organization. I've got the proud privilege, and Modi ji gave me this opportunity, and he took the lead. That 55 crore people, more than half of 1 billion, 55 crore people, 10 crore 74 lakh families have been taken into Ayushman Bharat and they have been given 5 lakh rupees annual health coverage for more than 2,075 diseases. In one and a half years, 12 crore people have taken the benefit of it. Not 12 crore, sorry, 12 lakh people have taken the benefit of it. And 8,500 crore rupees have been dispersed by Government of India for these people, for this. This is, and you know what means 55 crore? The whole of America, the whole of Canada, the whole of Mexico, the total population comes is our Ayushman Bharat. That is what we have to understand. And this is dedicated to the poorest of the poor. Who are they who are getting this benefit? Rickshaw wala, thele wala, redi wala, feri wala, maid servant, rajmistri, plumber, electrician, barber, cobbler, auto driver, driver's cleaner, house maid servant and the house servant also. This is category wise we have decided, and this is how we are working for them, and we are trying to see to it that they are brought into the Ayushman Bharat. So if we talk about the socio-economic change which is taking place, there are many programs, startups, stand-up, all these programs are dedicated to the people who did not get the opportunity. And Modi ji has come out with the policies which gives them the strength, and it is the empowerment which is bringing a change in the society. That is how we are working. I can talk on many policies and programs, but I have selected few on which I have talked. If I talk about the space development which has taken place, now how we have gone forward, that you have seen. If I talk about army, for last 20 years, not even a single pistol was purchased. Not even a single pistol. Today, 36 Rafale fighters are coming. 15 Chinook choppers have come. The whole aircraft fleet is being changed. Sukhoi is there. We have purchased 1,86,000 bulletproof jackets. Our soldiers were without bulletproof jackets. And now we are exporting bulletproof jackets. We have purchased 5 lakh assault rifles and replaced all old model ammunition. So a lot of change has taken place. ORP, one rank, one pension. 20 lakh cases have been settled. More than 12,000 crore rupees have been dispersed. Not even a single case left. India has changed under the dynamic leadership of Modi ji. And we feel proud that the time has come when we are seeing that on one hand, Modi ji is being taken, India is being looked with a lot of respect by Trump. At the same time, the Chinese president also comes here in Mahabaleshwaram. Mahabalipuram. And there we see our Modi ji in Indian, South Indian attire, receiving the president of China and having one-to-one discussion. It's not only the meeting of two states. It is the chemistry which works and how he has seen. And at the same time, if we talk about Japan, all countries want to. They may have differences among themselves, but all are with India. This is the international change which has taken place. And this is how we are going. So friends, on all walks of life, we have tried to see to it that we go forward and India becomes stronger and stronger. Although we know that there are a lot of detractors, but detractors keep detracting us, but we don't get detracted. We have to work and see to it that India becomes strong nation. And internationally, you must have felt it, that now everybody says proudly outside India that yes, we are Indians. Yes, we are Indians. And when they say, are you Modi supporter? They say, yes, we are Modi supporters. So even Indian diaspora outside has attained respectability. That is the change which has taken place. So I would once again thank you all for giving me a very patient hearing. A few stray ideas I had, which I shared with you. You have given me a very patient hearing. I must thank you. And I don't know whether I've been able to enlighten you on many issues or not, but that is what was in my mind, which I've tried to share with you. Thank you very much.